Hi all, and welcome to episode 2 of the Beginner's Guide to FlightGear. Today I'm going to walk you through the installation and first boot of the program. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check the first episode, and if you haven't grabbed a copy yet, go over to FlightGear SourceForge page, link in the description. First up, double click the installer and make yourself a cup of coffee. Windows will try to scan the 1.5GB file for the publisher's name, which is never listed, so this is going to take a while. Then hit yes on this window, or input your password if they ask for it, and then the installer window would appear. Accept the GPL and that you might have to disable your antivirus during installation, and you can pick where it goes. I recommend you pick somewhere on the second partition just to be safe, but you can keep the default if you want. The classic start menu and desktop icon options, and a final confirmation, and the installation finally starts. You can make yourself a second cup of tea if you want. The installation is finished, but the program will prepare its files the first time you start it, so why not do it now? Double click the FlightGear 2018.1 icon, and finish your cup of coffee while it's indexing its data files. Now that that's finished, we have one final step. Go to the Aircrafts tab, click Browse, and then add Default Hangar in order to download the all-you-can-eat plane buffet. So that's all for today, we'll explore this launcher more in the next episode.
Wow, I must be really hungry discussing all this food.
Anyway, be sure to check out some of my other videos on the right hand side, and subscribe at the bottom so you will never miss new videos almost every Saturday. Thanks for watching, this is Dorothy Kitty, and have a nice flight.